Hey creatures, it's your girl, Alea the Slayer of NYC Butterfly Braids Hair Story Podcast. Welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you how I install these knotless braids for my beautiful client. She has really long hair. Oh, before we get into all that, have you heard the word? Your girl has finally dropped my oils. Yep, this is, I think, the fourth edition. They are the best. I'm so happy to release these to you, and it's just like black girl magic in a bottle, like literally. And then I have my hair growth oil. They're both able to do repair and care, so mind you, you're getting a lot for your money. You're able to moisturize and seal with this product, which is a special treat. Smells great and it's great for you, so I hope you enjoy it. Check it out on hairstylesbyher.com. anyway, so yeah, we did these medium to large size knotless braids, and I think they came out pretty cool. Like I said, her hair real long, it's super fluffy. You know, I just moisturized it, and then I'm gonna show you like real time how I do my knotless braids. Y'all know I like to leave like the pull the strands, because knotless braids are feeding braids. You're gonna basically be feeding in smaller pieces at a time so that it looks like it's growing out your head. That's the whole point. Whereas regular box braids have like a big ass box, no, not a big ass box, have a big ass knot on the top of the braid, and they look not like they're growing out of your head, not usually. So yeah, you feed in small pieces. That's basically the trick to this. She wanted a lot of baby hair out. I'm a fan of leave some baby hair out and like let the rest come out on their own, because I like to my styles to last a long time. I feel like if I'm spending a grip to get my hair done, I want it to have phases. So I want it to be neat and cute for the first 2-3 to a month, you know what I mean, depending on how I maintain it. And then I want it to start popping out baby hairs everywhere and like looking real, that frizzy earthy natural look, like towards later, so I get like 2 looks out of it, you know what I mean. I don't want to leave a space, then I just got my hair done and I look like I had it in for 10 weeks. I noticed that people like that, but a lot of times y'all see people's pictures, and in their pictures, they had their braids in for a long time. So it's acclimated to them, super flexible. They're super like, you know, cute, whatever. And y'all want that right out the gate. And I'm like, sis, you are not Beyonce, okay? No offense, you are not I don't know any of these Instagram people that could get their hair done every Tuesday. You trying to keep this in for 2 months, let's be real, sis, let's be real, at least, right? I get it. I've been there. That's why I created DIY hair supply, because a lot of us do our own hair. So you trying to let this last, and I was one of y'all, last for weeks. So you don't want to leave here with your hair like falling out on day one. How far along do you think you're going to get? Let's be real. And I always try to tell people that. I'm like, sis, just let it happen. It's going to happen. Get your stuff neat here, because I don't live with you. I can't be touching you up every Tuesday. I'm booked and busy. So get your hair done securely here. And then over time, it gets looser. It gets like super boho-y. And you get 2 styles. You get the neat look, and then you get the messy look later. You just want the messy look out the gate. I love messy. Messy is fun. However, you're not rich. And if it's messy now, it's going to be messier. And you need to consider that, because it's just, to me, I think it's just time consuming to sit there for all them hours just to come out with your hair messed up, when it's going to get messed up later. And you can just wait for that part and then rock that. But whatever makes you happy, you know what I mean? Some people, they do have it like that, and it's nothing for them to, like, you know, get their hair done every 2 weeks. What type of girl are you? Do you like your hair like neat and together, or do you want it like falling off the bone? Imagine if I made you turkey wings and it was falling off the bones, and then I told you to carry it down the block. It's not gonna get far, it's falling off the bone. So think about that with your locks and your like styles. If it's falling off the damn frames when you leave, you're not gonna make it down the block, girl. Don't call me. So yeah, I like to do it secure, make sure it's super neat, so that later on it can get messy, loose, and you get 2 fabulous styles out of it. That's what you pay for. Hairstylesbyher.com. Oh, before you go, another thing that you need to know. DIY Hair Supply is my personal hair supply store. I've been selling hair for a long time through the website, through the DMs, through the internets. And now we're officially launching DIY Hair Supply. Follow us on Instagram at DIY Hair Supply on Twitter. And get a bookmark on that page so that you know Way to go. Also, make sure if you're listening to this on YouTube, you subscribe. And if you haven't already checked out NYC Butterfly Braids Hair Story Podcast, streaming on all platforms, then girl, you're not living your best life. I'm just going to call it what it is. Head on over to hairstylesbyher.com, hit that media tab, and listen to my podcast. You can also listen to it on Stitcher, Apple Play, Google Play, Spotify, anywhere you stream podcasts. You can listen to NYC Butterfly Braids Hair Story Podcast. Leave some butterflies in the comments so I know you stopped by. Till next time, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, take care of your hair, and get you some of them oils, okay? They're very affordable and the shipping is free. Bye.